sky is clear. Launching in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, launch.
Exciting morning. Everybody's getting ready for rocket launches. They've got 12 launch pads out there. Richard's getting registered for his launch to become level one certified.
Okay.
Flight card.
Yeah. Well, get the rocket ready. Come see this guy Mike with Tripoli. He'll check it out. Set it up for a flight.
We got it all fixed up. So there's Richard in his parachute. We've got the rocket transport system all rigged up on the air conditioner unit. What's next, Rich?
Never done this, so. Remember, no open flames.
What's there to do to it now?
Put the ejection charge. We adjusted the timing, right? To 10 seconds. Put the black powder in for the ejection charge.
Richard has calculated the point he wants the parachute to eject as 10 seconds from the end of the motor burn. That's an approximate time shortly after the rocket is expected to reach apogee, its maximum height of about 3,000 feet. It's based on calculations of velocity, considering the rocket's weight, the motor's thrust, plus other variables including force and aerodynamic drag. If the parachute ejects too soon while the rocket is still ascending, the force will likely detach the cord or it will zipper, which is when the cord slices a hole down the side of the rocket. If the parachute ejects too late, the speed can cause the same problems or the canopy might not inflate. In either of those cases, it's considered an unsuccessful flight and failure for level one certification. So, fingers crossed.
What are you worried about the most?
It's coming up.
Yeah.
Actually, right now, after doing that ejection charge, since I've never done that before, I don't know if that's the right way.
How'd you learn to pack the chute like that?
YouTube,
of course. Because the ejection charge is hot, it could burn your parachute.
We'll burn your parachute, yeah. Fireproof.
How did you decide how tight of a fit to make the nose?
Rock, paper, scissors. See, my question is that does the black powder, some of the black powder goes through that little hole. Does most of it supposed to go through the hole? Or is most of it supposed to stay on the outside of the hole?
Somebody you can ask.
Yes.
We ready to fly? This is exciting. They're doing launches out here on the pad. Oh, you got more people marching out there with some rockets.
Might be the only last time that it's like this in one piece.
Take a good look.
Out on E6, we got continuity. Brian's Gemini flying in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This is going to burn forever. That was a really good motor.
Wow, nice.
Wow, comes down fast, too.
It is.
Oh, he's going to have a secondary.
Good luck, Bob. Sky's clear. Star level 2, a Tripoli level 2 going in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Low and slow, I like it. And then, hey, congratulations, welcome to level 2.
Nice.
Okay, hold just a second, I'm gonna launch the back row and then I will open the range. D6, we got continuity. J355 going in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Well, I heard it.
Yeah.
Looks like we lost continuity. Let me try it again. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. No joy, you're gonna have to recycle that igniter there.
Level 1, right?
Yeah.
Adam had E4.
All right, tell me about it.
Usman from Los Angeles. Did I get it right? Yes. All right.
Okay.
Another, I think this is a TARP also on an F26. Adam had E4.
A DMS.
E4, motor. We got continuity. This guy's perfect. Our team going in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
You've got an adapter in there.
Yeah, okay. I went down from, it comes with a 14. The second delay.
Uh-huh.
So through the calculations, uh-huh, it's like 10.33. So
okay.
I took it to 10.
That's fine. It's close enough.
Everything. The
You got some vent holes there. Mm-hmm. That moose for you in there.
And then out of pad E6.
And I want to be able to, my first impression is a little bit loose. Okay, and you can just get a piece of masking tape and put it on there. What happens if it's too loose is it will go up and it can separate under drag. Once the motor burns out, and if you've got a lot of drag, you have some pretty big fins, it could separate. So what I'll do is I'll pick the rocket up and I'll just shake it a little bit. You want to be able to pick it up so it holds, and then just kind of shake it a little bit and it'll start to come loose.
Okay.
That's kind of my rule of thumb. So if you want to put... All the way up, okay? Go like that, or like that. Put some tape around it to hold it in place. Going out there and... Okay. Put it on the rail. Okay. Have it in the upright position. Put your igniter in. Okay. Tape it. Hook up your leads. Make sure they're not touching metal or touching each other. And then there's a button on the pad box that's over by E that corresponds to your launch pad number. You press that button and that checks your continuity. You get a loud beep, you're good. You don't get any noise, then there's the leads are touching each other, they're touching metal, there's something wrong. All right, good luck.
Thank you. What do you got there?
The igniter that goes up the wazoo.
Did you say the wazoo? Gosh, thank you.
Oh, that's a loud beep.
Let's go.
All right. Wait, so you said
the big question mark is if the chute deploys on time, comes out, unfurls, untangled, right?
Yeah.
And that's the biggest, not doing a core sample.
What's a core sample? We saw one that just came straight.
Yeah, but he bounced off the desert floor.
Oh, it actually has a stick in?
They actually take a core sample. It sticks in into the dirt.
At E5, we have Richard Fujikawa. This is a certain flight. Hi, Gosby, are you watching? Hi. Mike Gosby.
Yeah.
Okay. Richard.
Range is clear, sky is clear. Launching in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, launch. Nice straight flight up. Going over the cup in a bit. Looks like we've got a shoot. Welcome to high power.
Hey. Congratulations. You did it.
The horse? Congratulations. Is that L3 or L2?
One. That was his first flight.
Oh. That was a big motor. What motor was that? G?
I?
Oh, is this that your first one's an I?
Yeah.
Get over.
Just, yeah, it would be a mess.
Let's see how your parachute's doing there.
Do they have a service to go pick them up?
Yeah, right. Sometimes I have to go with Dean Buggy. Like, can I hit your ride? Dean Buggy.
All right, we're going to go for a walk, huh?
Yeah. You going to stay here?
I'll come with you. How long have we been walking?
45. 2,000 years later.
Is this your rocket?
That one's bright orange. Nomax doesn't look so bright orange.
Nice.
Ta-da.
Hey everybody, Richard and his Jody's. So we made it back and now we're just waiting for the certification guy. Yeah, to sign you off on your level one. So he's just to basically check that your rocket did land in flight worthy condition.
Level zero. Zero. Goes to one.
Back. They look good, huh?
What you doing there, Richard?
Second Saturday.
Spending your money.
Bring your rockets up.
Get yourself a new rocket.
Motor.
Oh, that's what I meant. You know. What you got there, Richard?
That's a 54 millimeter. And this is a 38 millimeter extended.
That's for your level 2 certification?
Yeah. This was the level 1.
Oh, you happy boy. Boys and their toys. When's level 2?
Next month.
Already? You gonna do level 3 for Rockstock?
Yeah, that's a big one.